I'm excited about 2021 seminars.
I'm excited about 2021 in general.
Yeah, I'm excited about, you know, whatever happens in 2021, we're pivoting like fuck. I think we both might write books on separate things.
Books.
Ebooks. It might fucking happen. Guys, it might happen. It might happen.
Yeah.
Don't tell people what they're for.
I can't. Mm-mm.
Because I think you're going to surprise people. I'm going to surprise people too. Mm-hmm. Next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Yeah! We're live.
Just yawning.
So we open up. We open up every show from now on with yawning.
I feel like that's sort of like the theme.
It's our new intro.
I'm like not even that tired though. It's just like it's a stress yawn. It's a stress yawn.
Well, how did you know?
As a joke, because everybody talks about dogs stress
yawning. Oh, right. Do you want to lick your lips now? Once every 23 seconds. Hey, everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Sally Canine Training and with the wonderful Joelle. And this is the What Would Jeff Do show. It's a live show. We are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Wednesdays, we're on Patreon only, but we're thinking about shaking that up a little bit. We just started doing it, but Joelle and I came up with a new idea to still add even more value to the Patreon channel and bring back the Wednesday show here. We're just going back and forth. We just want to be able to give as much free content to help as many people as possible. That's the gist of what we do.
Sometimes like when we're traveling, we don't even make the Wednesday show.
That's the problem. Not only the Wednesday show, sometimes we miss the Monday show, sometimes we miss a Friday show, and we'll be traveling a lot. So it's a little bit challenging right now. We're still trying to get,
trying to get our shit together.
12 years of these shows. I'm trying to get my shit together still. But anyway, I appreciate all of you. So the What Would Jeff Do show, it's a problem-solving show. The Jeff Gellman Seminars, problem-solving seminars, problem-solving seminars, which we just finished up in Austin. Chloe, hostess with the mostest, thank you so much. And we just booked dates for next year. And I'll be announcing those tomorrow. Once I put the event up, it'll go live tomorrow. Don't forget, we're going to be in Ramona, California very soon. After that, we're going to be in Phoenix and then back to Providence. So we still got 3 more seminars this year. We're going to kick some major ass, help some major people, eliminate some major pain, and expand some people's life. And yeah. I'm really excited about that. I think the expansion of people's life is what I really like the most. Mm-hmm. And then eliminating pain. Eliminating pain, number one. Expanding life, number two. I think that is really, really helpful. So you're going to hear me use the word punishment a lot. Punishment has been hijacked by people to mean abuse. It's the farthest thing from abuse. It's just the opposite of a reward. Mm-hmm. Yes, reward. No, consequence. That's it. It's simple concepts. Yep. Yes, increases a behavior. No, decreases and eliminates a behavior.
Decreases.
That's when your behavior has got perfect lines. That's right.
The lack of lines. That's right. Decreases.
No. Oh my God.
No creases.
Gellman, he uses hot irons on dogs. I can see it now. And then we have the wonderful training center here, which we're doing boarding trains. We're still open. We are an essential business because we do boarding here. We do. We have a lot of first responders, a lot of nurses, doctors, firefighters, police officers who use us daily. So they need us to be here, and we are here, and we are always here for you. Also, we're doing one-on-ones. In fact, we have a one-on-one photo will probably go up tomorrow. I'm personally doing all the one-on-ones, which for a lot of people is really exciting because we're going old school. We're going back to the day when Jeff trained dogs.
Yep.
And then we also do a lot of online consults. A lot of the answers that I give on this show, it might seem like I'm being sort of like abrupt, snarky, and I'm like, you need to do an online consult. I'm not saying that so you'll do online consults. I'm saying it because these questions are complicated.
Aggression and stuff, you can't. Yeah, it's like, you can't answer
like,
online.
How do I sell my aggressive dog? I'm like, like that's an hour minimum. That's like, yeah, you know, 100 different things you need to do. And then the training center we do, you know, the whole nine yards. We do it all here. But anyway, ask your question. You've got a little comment box in the bottom. Ask your question there. On YouTube, you can do something called Top Chat, and your question does get to the top of the queue. We do answer that first. Why? You throw us a little bit of cash. You sort of become a VIP, top of the queue, but you do not have to pay to play. We get through as many questions as possible in the hour. And obviously, the earlier you get on the show, you get your questions answered. And here we go.
Here we go.
Let's go.
Kathy B. Hey, everyone.
Kathy B. Hey, Kathy. Madly in love with you. How are you?
Melissa said good evening and happy Monday.
Melissa, I thank you for being here every show. Thank you so much.
Dixie says hello. Hello, Dixie.
Hey, Dixie. How are you? That's my aunt's name.
You like cut off there. Did you choke on air or something?
Yes, I did.
Got it.
I held a burp in.
Melissa posted the link to Patreon channel. I know what you did. I was trying to be politically correct about it.
Right. So the Patreon channel is great because there's every single video on the Patreon channel is not seen anywhere else. A lot of seminar videos are there. Also, we do our Tuesday Zoom room there, which is original as well. Next.
Dan, thank you guys. You've helped so much.
Dan, thank you. That means you've been kicking ass. Do you know what I just had? I just did some Napoleon Dynamite action. I just had some tots.
Oh, those tater tots are so good.
I had tots. I had tots with hot sauce. Guess what I had for lunch?
Tots.
With cocktail sauce.
What, are you just living off tater tots today?
Oh, No. I had vegetables.
Oh, okay.
I had protein.
I was about to say, what the hell?
Oh, no. But guess what I also had?
Tots.
There's no good Brussels sprout movie. Like quotes you can do. There's no good like salmon quotes you can do. But tots? Napoleon Dynamite. You know, you can't. That's a go-to. Vote for Pedro, buddy. Vote for Pedro. Next.
Ashley, happy Monday, everyone. Looking forward to a great show. Throw in some rants. Even better night, LOL.
We'll see.
Ashley is... Oh, I don't know if I should announce it on here. She DM'd me something on Instagram that you should know about.
Go ahead.
Bara, I don't know if she wants people knowing.
Yeah, just throw it out there. We'll find out. Ashley's pretty transparent.
She's getting a dog. A certain type of dog.
Okay.
A certain type of dog.
Okay.
A Malinois.
Personal.
Yeah.
Ashley.
It's so cute.
You're fucked. Next.
Bara said hello, J&J from San
Mateo. Oh, look at that. Bara, I love it. I love your name, Bara, and I love San Mateo.
Where's that?
It's right below San...
Yeah, I knew you were going to fucking...
San Mateo, okay. It's either California, New Mexico, or Arizona.
I was thinking New Mexico
for some reason. Where's San Mateo?
Tosh says, hey, guys.
Tosh is from New Zealand. Tosh, we love you. Hope you're feeling healthy.
Jacob, I use a lot of your techniques to walk my dog, but he still wants to be the leader. He jumps up when I give him a correction.
So your dog is being pushy and snotty. Try the spatial pressure video. Also, your dog is not taking you seriously. So also, what's the rest of the day look like? Hold your dog accountable, not just on the walk, but in every part of the day. Next.
Laura says, hey, guys.
Laura, how are you?
Be free dog training. Client has a Great Dane that is 6 months old, won't stop peeing in the crate, poops and sits in his mess. Oh, God, dirty dog. She has him regulated on going out, regulates food and water intake. I honestly don't know what to tell them to do. No UTI.
So no UTI. I would check for worms. And also, you might have to also tell them to make an Excel spreadsheet, keep track of all the potty. Also, make sure the food intake and the water intake is highly controlled. Also, I have to sneeze, so talk.
About the dog going in the crate. That's a hard one.
Okay. You can stop talking if you want to. I mean, I don't want you to stop talking because you're so smart.
Sometimes we make it so that the dog just has to lay down in the crate all the time.
So control down all the time. And then also, definitely some people don't monitor the food in the water.
But she said they are.
Well, they said no UTI.
She said monitoring food and water.
You might have to do a better job of it.
Has him regulated on going out. Regulates food, water intake.
There's something missing.
I make sure that dog's laying down all the time.
Yeah, all the time. Next.
Jamie said, do you offer discounts for first responders?
Unfortunately, we don't. But I have mad respect for first responders. This is the thing, guys. I give out over $100,000 a year in free hands-on training. We give out thousands of hours of free advice. This show right now is free. We make videos, we have podcasts. I do so much stuff, but unfortunately and I love my military. I love my police officers. I love my first responders. I have mad respect. All I can say is thank you so much, but unfortunately I can't. I am a business. We are in the middle of a crisis and a worldwide pandemic. I need to generate revenue. I need to keep my doors open. So the cash flow has to stay there. Next.
Nicole, newer, but love your content.
Thank you so much. So newer is fine. And thank you so much for sticking around. I really, really appreciate that.
Lisa, my Aussie is so motivated to train and rocks diving, agility, barn hunt, scent work, but is such an asshole. She's reactive, highly sensitive. How do I rein in her behavior?
So this is it, Lisa. You've got to have two worlds, work world and pet dog world. Pet dog world, we work on calmness, duration place, duration downs, sitting in chairs, okay? Low drive stuff. You will not ruin the drive. So your trainers now that you work on and all those things are going to say everything I tell you is wrong because they don't know how to live in the two worlds. I know how to live in two worlds. I own high drive dogs, but I also know how to control the drive. You're a pet right now. Now you're a working dog. You're a pet. You're a working dog. You don't take away from the drive. So duration things, hold your dog accountable, correct for being out of control, teach your dog default place, default down, not as a trick, but as a lifestyle. Next.
I was just thinking today it poured. Our guys only went out for one little check it session.
I did two, but still.
Mine haven't done anything.
It doesn't make a difference. It's like we knew this morning when we were actually going to our normal hike, it downpoured. Now, I've walked in the rain. You've walked in the rain. But today we were both like.
It was. They didn't even want to run. It was raining bad.
But still, we were both like, you know what? No. Not today.
I had so much to do today. They've done nothing but sleep.
Yeah, and you know what? Guess what?
Sorry, guys.
They'll do fine. Next.
Dan, I messaged you guys today about my dog who is aggressive toward my fiance. While the dog was laying, my fiance went to pet her and give her a kiss, and the dog bit her very hard on the hand.
Okay, so Dan, number one, I usually give people a cut and paste response saying, Dan, just think about this. How many messages do you think I get a day? Dozens. Some days I've gotten over 100. I cannot answer these. I just can't. I don't have the time to. It's not that I don't care. So I tell people, first of all, you need a one-on-one. You need a one-on-one. But I would make a couple of suggestions. Right now, have your fiance stop kissing the dog. Number two, when the dog is lying down, stop petting the dog. Should you be able to pet the dog lying down? Yes, you should. For now, don't do it. Is that the final answer? No, it's not. But kissing, no kissing of the dog. It makes your fiance happy. The dog doesn't give a shit. Okay? Next.
Joanna, I got so much helpful tips from you when my dog was a puppy and he got punished. And now 3 years later, he's an amazing dog.
Great. So punished, exactly. Punished for noncompliance of a known behavior. Apply a punisher for an unwanted behavior. Also, that's just one part of it. That's 5% of the dog's world, if 5%. Remember, there's 86,400 seconds in a day. Applying a punisher is, you know, some days it's 1 second, some days it's three, some days it's 10. 86,400 seconds in a day. Our boarding trains are 6 weeks long. That's 3.6 million seconds. Scale this, folks. Never punish a dog. It's like, are you serious? Come on now. Next.
Mimi, when you bring your board and train dogs into stores, do you do engagement drills in the parking lot before entering the store to get the dogs to focus on the handler? If so, what drills?
No, we don't. We just walk right in. We don't tire them out. We just go, I'm going from the car in. Right in. Boom. Point A, point B. We don't tire them out. We just go. Next.
Dan said tots are the best.
Dan, tots are the best. And I make them in an air fryer. Joelle has an air fryer that I hijacked.
He literally confiscated it. It's not even mine anymore.
Well,
I said you could have it.
Thank you very much. So technically, you gifted it.
Because you were using it so much. I'm like, but, just take it.
Right. But I didn't take it. It's still there. You still have access to it. And now, and you don't seem to mind. Now, what you would mind is, what's the one, what is, I already know what it is. What is the one thing in the kitchen, if I did hijack it, you would literally probably stick a knife in my eyeballs?
Probably my waffle maker.
Bingo, bingo.
Touch that.
And if you don't understand what her waffle maker is, go to Joelle's Instagram page and there'll be a link to it on this right now. There's also a link to this on my Instagram page. And there is the one of the most stunning videos of the waffle maker in use that I've ever seen. It is so well done.
So stunning, making it, waffles. It,
no. Do not discount that fucking video. That's like Spielberg shit. I'm sorry. That's a goddamn fucking good video.
All right. $5 top chat from Pat. Just got my GSD back from a 2-week board and train. I can't take his submissive peeing. What's a good way to get his e-collar on without him peeing?
That's a rough one. I would have him go into a downstay, put it on. Try that next.
Kathy said, ugh, Napoleon Dynamite.
Whoa. Back up. Ugh, as in.
It is kind of a stupid movie. It's like stupid humor. It's not for everybody.
No. It's a decent movie though.
It's like a one-time watch for me.
Okay. Did you turn it off halfway through?
No.
Okay. So it's not the worst.
I like the alpaca. Tino, you fat lard. Come get some ham.
Yeah. Vote for Pedro. I mean, there's some funny stuff. There's some really funny.
Sleeves. Yeah. It's like, it's got a lot of one-liners.
Yeah. Okay. And you smile when you talk about it.
Yeah, but I don't think I'd ever watch it again.
And now you're laughing. Okay. Thank you.
Emma, why do you suggest to train dogs separately?
Well, I don't. At the beginning, I suggest train dogs separately. At the beginning, we train them in a sterile environment. They learn better. But eventually, no, train them all together. But at the very, very beginning, train them separately. Because distractions make it difficult. It's the same with humans. We learn easily in a sterile environment. And then eventually, yeah, we want to put massive pressure on dogs. But at the beginning, it's much easier to teach them by themselves. Next.
Emma, I already read that. Nicole, our now 4-month-old Malinois GSD will not leave leash alone at all. Insists on tugging, alligator roll and all. How to stop?
Bonk the dog. No bonk when it does that shit. Next.
Pat said, LOL, I just watched that today.
Napoleon Dynamite?
Napoleon Dynamite.
Pat.
So random.
You really watched Napoleon Dynamite today? What's the chances?
I don't know.
What are the chances? What's the chance somebody would watch Napoleon Dynamite today?
If it's one of your favorite movies.
Yeah, but why today, though? I mean, that thing was done a long time ago. Good for you,
Pat. I still watch Christmas Vacation every year.
But that makes sense. So
the history of forever.
So I bet you 25% of the population is watching Christmas movies right now, if not more.
True, but I like watching the summertime because that's just funny.
Nice. Next.
Watch it year-round. Joe, if your dog is at a working level of 11 but goes into drive and they see other dogs, some of them have like a hardcore dream.
Yep.
What level would you put the e-collar at to give a hard punisher to stop loading? Also, the dog whines in crate before feeding. So what level would you put it at for that type of correction?
So who's that, Joe?
Yeah.
Joe, this is what you're going to do. Today is what? Monday? Between now and Friday, you're going to have answers to that, and you're going to tell me what the answers are. Okay? Got it? You tell me. I don't know. You tell me. Figure it out. And I'm not saying it to be a dick. I'm saying it because you tell me. I'm not going to tell you. You know why? I don't know. I don't know what level. Level 46. Come on, Joe.
Dog might scream its head off.
I don't know. You tell me. You do fishing. Like, up and down, up and down, up and down. What level is it? Hey, level 37 worked. There it goes. Next.
Pat, hello, guys. How are you?
How are you doing?
I'm good.
I'm doing really good.
It's productive as fuck today.
You were really productive.
Freaking took apart a whole deer for the damn dogs.
That's like part of your day.
Oh, I know. I got so much done.
I saw you disappear. That's like when you took your watch off, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like
rolled sleeves up.
So when I saw Joelle, she has an Apple Watch, and I saw her watch on the table there. I'm like, she's doing something messy. Yeah. Yeah, you never take it off. So you're like, you're knee deep in deer carcass. Yeah, and you posted up on your Instagram stories, I believe. Mm-hmm. So guys, jump on to both our Instagram stories, and our stories are very different. They're very, very different because we have different lives. So I commented a lot on your stories today. You had a lot of great content on your stories. You did really, really great. Yeah, you're welcome. Next.
Kristen, you guys rock. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Kristen.
Julie, happy Thanksgiving, J&J.
So for all thank the you, folks Julie. Out there, whether you celebrate, you know, the holidays, whether it's Christmas or Thanksgiving, which are the two most American traditional ones. We have an international audience. We also have people from different religious denominations. I understand that. But whatever I can say is happy holidays to all, but also happy day, happy life, happy 2020, happy, you know, the year of the big test. And, you know, and all I can say is I love all of you. Next.
I'm making a gluten-free, dairy-free green bean casserole for Thursday. Just saying, it's going to be awesome.
Is that a question?
No, I'm just saying.
Oh, you
I'm
are.
I'm so excited.
Yes.
Yeah, what side dishes I can eat.
Yes, next.
Barra, California, near San Jose. See you at the seminar.
Awesome.
Ooh, I thought it was in New Mexico.
So good. So, yes, we've got a seminar coming up in good old San Jose. I'm excited about that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a long way away.
I'm excited about 2021 seminars.
I'm excited about 2021 in general.
Yeah, I'm excited about, you know, whatever happens in 2021, we're pivoting like fuck. I think we both might write books on separate things.
Books.
Ebooks. It might fucking happen. Guys, it might happen. It might happen.
Yeah.
Don't tell people what they're for.
I can't. Mm-mm.
Because I think you're going to surprise people. I'm going to surprise people too. Mm-hmm. Next.
Jacob, thank you. Love all your stuff.
Jacob, thank you so much.
John, dog aggressive on leash to dogs, barking like crazy. Tried e-collar with no luck. I walk the other way, but he still lunges and acts crazy until we get completely out of sight.
Okay, that's not aggression. That's reactivity. So, John, call it reactivity. It's not aggression. Number two, your timing is off. As soon as the dog loads, meaning it's soon, okay, alcoholic in rehab, walks to the bar, puts its hand on the door of the bar. Correction happens when the alcoholic thinks about going into the bar. Not with a hand on the bar, not in the bar, not on the bar stool, not after the first drink. When they think about going to the bar, boom, correction. Same thing with the dog. Next.
The vertically challenged. Hey, you haven't been on in a while. Jeff, can you correct a dog for anxious panting? Dog paces in the house even when people are home. It's exercise on a 4-mile run a day.
Okay, more exercise will not help this at all. This is a separate issue. Teach the dog place, reinforce place, have the dog do it down. Yes, you can correct all of those things. Next.
Vincent, hi guys. I hope all is well. How to stop the exceeding licking?
You know, what's the dog licking? Help me out here. Furniture, you, is it? It's paws. Help me out there. Next.
Kathy, teaching puppy out command using two lines to people, saying out, then gentle leash pressure. Is that the best way? Thanks in advance.
How old is the dog? We usually do a pop, or we use a remote collar. Next.
Joanna. Interesting fact, when my dog decides to be naughty, he stops in his tracks and thinks. Really weird to see a dog thinking through and deciding to be naughty. Listen to Jeff. Punishment is needed for dogs.
You know, dogs absolutely. Okay, some dogs do stupid stuff because they've never been told differently. Mm-hmm. Some dogs absolutely, absolutely know that it's wrong.
Oh, yeah.
And will go, you know what?
I've seen it before too. They'll be like, I want to do something, and they'll like look over their shoulder.
Yep.
And like, I'm gonna do it anyway.
I'm gonna do it anyway. Mm-hmm. I don't give a fuck what you think.
Yep.
Yep. Next.
$5 top chat from Travis. Stopping in for support. Thanks for all our classes with Higgins the pug. He's doing great this week.
So good. Happy. And you know what? I'm really happy with you. I'm happy with the human change. That's the couple that comes in with a pug.
He's doing great. They already got him dragging a line.
Yep. And I'm really happy with you guys. I'm really happy with the two of you. please tell your wife that as well. And I did answer your question. You emailed me. I hope you got it. And I'm just saying,
video of them going up.
Yep. I'm really, really proud of the two of you. I really, really am. Thank you so much. Thank you for the kind words. Next.
Be Free Dog Training said, thanks.
I hope you're doing well. You tell Charlotte, I love her. Tell her Uncle Jeff says hello. And tell her to send me a little video because I miss her. Next.
Eddie, have to sneeze. Talk killed me. Hope you hear awesome tonight.
Yeah, it's we don't
can't have, put me on the spot like that. I'm like a deer in headlights. I'm like, what do I talk about?
But you know what though? It's like I gotta sneeze sometimes.
All I can talk about is like food and
workout. No, Jesus Christ, Joelle. You could fucking talk about dog
training.
You can talk about dog training just like I can. Give me a break.
B, have you ever branched out into dog sport? Mondio, French, KNVP, IPO?
Nope. And I have no interest. That's not my gig. First of all, I have mad respect for the people that do it. Mad respect for the trainers. It's a totally different skill set. And but that's not something I do. Next.
Erica, husband moved out and 2-year-old stays with him here and there. Seems she barked a lot when he left for an hour or so. We've always taken her everywhere, and she's exposed to lots of different people. Recommend the bark collar or no?
I would actually get a remote collar instead of the bark collar. Bark collar is great when there's nobody around. But the remote collar is great when there is somebody there because you can say no and then correct. And you can make sure you're at the right level. Next.
Lori, got a dog, obedient, but hard-headed, stubborn to the T all the time. What to do for a shake-up? Duration? He crates all day for work.
Okay, hard-headed is lack of motivation. You meaning you don't know how to motivate the dog. Not your fault, but you need to figure out what the motivator is. So I just did a video today. I'll be putting it up. There is a video that went up today, the one that you can get up onto Facebook, but we got up onto Instagram that talks about like some dogs they've got really no food drive and stuff.
I just didn't talk about that.
So which one is that?
The crate drill. The
crate drill is correct. Okay.
I think you might have mentioned, like, why aren't you giving it food? But you're like, because I don't, like, this isn't a food
protocol. Yeah, right. There is another one that's going up tomorrow. It's the man in the arena video. No, yours was the man in the arena. Mine is What Would Jeff Do Goes Deep. That's going up tomorrow. It will talk about that a lot, about different motivators. Next.
Erica, 2-year-old golden doodle, LOL. What? I don't know.
What's that about?
I don't know.
Was that the licking dog? I still need to know what it's licking. Yep, next.
Ed, how are y'all tonight? You once said to work for free to gain experience. Does that include working for someone with a different positive only philosophy?
Absolutely. This is the thing, guys.
You can still learn.
Like we use positive reinforcement to train all the obedience commands.
Yeah, we should learn how to do clicker and counter.
Yes, we do tons. How do you think we train dogs to do stuff? Positive reinforcement.
Shocker.
You know, that's what we do. But you know what? Most people don't know how to stop unwanted behaviors because they don't have the skill set. Next.
Joseph, hi Jeff, you're the best. I'm a dog trainer and I applied or combined my method and yours, and it's the best for me. Just tonight, I stopped the dog from being very aggressive to people and dogs. This dog is seriously aggressive, and now the owner is so happy with the result and the neighbors as well. Nice. Keep it up, guys. You're the best of all the trainers out there.
So, first of all, Joseph, thank you so much. But on that note, I really, really want you to know there are some incredible dog trainers out there with much better skill set than me. You know, and as well as there's incredible dog trainers out there in general, but thank you for the compliment. I really, really appreciate it. And then also, I'm really proud of you for also picking out what works for you that I do and incorporating it into your work for a more well-rounded training program. That I like a lot. So kudos to you. Next.
Joe, J&J, thank you both so much. I was able to train all three German Shepherds to be around livestock and herd nice. Both my cattle and chickens without any injuries, from city dogs to herding on the ranch. Thank yes. you.
Yes, good. So, Joe, first of all, Joe Vito, did you ever work at Camille's Roman Garden back in 1986?
Stop. City life, though.
Right. Yeah.
Did you live in Providence, Joe?
Yeah. There was a waiter named Jovino. He worked at Camille's Roman Garden. We've passed it before. That was back when it was all mob. And, you know, it was just like, you know, Rhode Island, if you don't know, it's like mob town. And it was
imagine that. He's like, it is me.
Yeah. But Jovino is a popular name, especially in Rhode Island and New England. So kudos to you for doing all that hard work. And if anybody knows anything about taking a city dog or any dog and getting them around any type of livestock and not killing them, that's an accomplishment. Mm-hmm. Next.
CT Vader. Hi, all.
Hey, how are you, CT?
Jacob, my border collie is super high energy, 8 months old. Would Frisbee be a good energy release that can double as a training tool?
So, Jacob, you got a border collie. I have not met, I don't think I can say any, but very few low energy border collies. Okay. So, number one, train up the dog in all the basic obedience commands. Learn how to correct unwanted behavior. But yes, definitely look into Frisbee as your job for the dog. Next.
Kathleen, hi guys. Probably can't stay, but I'll catch the replay. Great video on the crate drills today. Talk to you later.
Kathleen, thank you so much. Hey, Joelle, Kathleen. You edited that one, right? So Joelle did a fantastic job editing that. Also, if anybody needs videos edited or help with their social media, we actually do have a company on that. And I'm sure Melissa will throw up the link to that.
Melissa posted the link to my Instagram. Thank you, Melissa.
Oh, join. Here we go. Yep. Guys. Yep. Yep. We are doing some promotion tonight. And why are we a little bit more promotion now? And I think because we're turning more into a virtual world, and we're actually pivoting and doing more virtual stuff. So we've got a lot of people know how to get a hold of us.
Yeah.
It's like, and you know, I think virtual is where we're going. And you know, we will not be exclusively virtual, but Joelle has got everything from her diet. I hate to use the word diet, her macro plans to physical fitness. She's got a wonderful Patreon channel. There's a link on her Instagram channel, and there's some fantastic stuff there. And I'm so, so, so proud of her. And I remember a year ago when you were really hesitant to it. And then I'm seeing you now, and I'm like, you have fucking grown so much. And I'm just really super proud of you.
Thanks.
I really, really am. Next.
CT Vader, just wanted to pop in and say happy Thanksgiving. Try to take some time off and relax.
So CT Vader, number one, happy Thanksgiving to you and your loved ones. Number two, I will not be taking any time off. I will be doubling down on my work. But guess what? That's what I do. That's what business owners do. Next.
Erica said yes. Oh, the dog that's licking is a golden doodle.
I still need to know what it's licking. Erica, answer the fucking question.
What is the golden doodle licking, Erica?
You know, is it licking its balls? Help me out here.
Renee, I'm from Puerto Rico, and I have an American Staffordshire. God darn it. Freaking Franks. Got bumped. Shit. Hold on.
Why do you have to yell at the Puerto Rican people?
Why does this thing hate me? Ay, ay, ay. Aye, aye, aye.
I think you're down.
No. Oh.
Yep.
Talk. Oh, okay. AKA Pitbull. And I watch a lot of your videos to train him. Thanks for all you do.
So, number one, haven't been to Puerto Rico yet, but we'll get there. Love you.
Pat said, I love that movie. Gosh.
See?
Gosh. Freaking idiots.
Oh. I don't like that movie. Meanwhile, you haven't stopped fucking quoting it.
It's hard not to.
Oh. Oh, God. I don't like that movie. Stupid. I don't like that movie. But I know it by heart.
Debbie, sorry I'm new and I love what I've learned so far.
Good.
My question is, our trainer had us purchase a Springer prong collar. However, it does not have the chain with the ring that spins. I spent last weekend watching Solid Canine Training Marathon and watched the videos about the prong. The collar definitely works, but I'd like to understand the difference in the collars and should we purchase a new one? The bonker is amazing. My dog is like a different dog with me now. She would listen and obey.
Interesting. Throwing a cotton towel at your dog works. No, you've got a different type of collar. It's got two rings on it.
Yeah.
And probably one of those rings has a little tiny silver tab that says it's from Herm Springer, right? Don't worry about it. You're doing fine. Next. Yeah.
Jeff, how do you scale your punishers when working with puppies through to
adulthood? So definitely when they're a puppy, like 12 weeks old, 14 weeks old, which you can punish a dog for jumping and whining and nipping, just scale it. Just scale it down. Just do appropriate. Just do what you feel is appropriate. Next.
Nicole, thank you. Bonking so will continue.
So bonking is fantastic. I will not stop. It seems like people have commented. I've been talking about it a lot. And why do I talk about it so much? Because it worked. If you go to our stories right now, I did a little tie phrase. I don't know if you saw that.
I did.
But I did a little tie.
Did you like Google Translate for that?
No, I actually talked to the owner that's from Thailand that got bonked by her
freaking wooden shoe.
By her it was a wooden spoon. It's like, yeah.
Wooden sandal.
Sandal, yes.
$4.99 top chat. Looks like from the Noble Dogs.
Hey, Grant.
When and how do you start e-collar? Sit. Always after, come, and place or mastered e-collar?
No. Actually, we would do sit after place. Mm-hmm. After place. Next. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Hold on. You can incorporate sit right training into place as well as recall. As well as recall. Next.
Kathy, would there be zero chance I'd watch Napoleon Dynamite, but Christmas Vacation, that's a must. Too damn funny. Shitter's full. Ha ha ha.
Okay.
Merry Christmas.
Okay.
Shitter's full.
Kathy B.
He's pumping it into a fucking storm drain.
Kathy B. Kathy B.
Cousin Eddie.
Kathy B.
I think we all have a Cousin Eddie, though.
I think, given the right moment, you'd watch Napoleon Dynamite. Next.
Ace Dog Academy. Any tips to get puppy to down and crate without e-collar?
Sure. Leash pressure. Next. Or food lure.
CT Vader, I have an actual question. When do you know when to move up from a Herm Springer to 2.5 to 3 millimeters?
Believe it or not, you can actually just stay at 2.25 and just add links. Next.
Melissa posted the link to your Instagram.
Thank you. Instagram is great. You know why? The stories are really, really good. Next.
Jackie, thank you for putting out great balanced content.
Jackie, thank you so much for incorporating it into your life. I really appreciate it. I want you to know I appreciate every single one of you who consumes and applies the content. Next.
Marnie Cool Dog. Hey, you haven't been on here forever. Hey, y'all. Yes, San Jose. I'll see you again.
So, Marnie Cool Dog, I want you to know that I consume your content, and I'm fucking impressed. Next.
Virginia, should I let the dog tell me when he needs to go potty or have a set time?
Both. You pick. What I do is I take my dogs out. Like, for instance, after the show, I'll do last call with my dogs. First thing in the morning, I let them out. And then we go hiking in the woods after we work out. So I usually don't tell my dogs. My dogs usually don't tell me when they have to go to the bathroom. I usually just put them on a schedule. Next.
Lori, why can't I see the earlier questions Facebook update?
I don't know. We don't see what you see. Next.
Kathy B, very young pup, approximately 10 or 11 weeks.
So I would scale it down a lot. Next.
Kelly, hey guys, if I'm working dog on duration while at work, if someone pets him, as long as he doesn't move, it's okay, correct?
Personal choice. To me, I would get my dog. I would tell people to leave my dog alone, and I'm trying to get my dog to exist and ignore people. Next.
Emma, what age do you start on the e-collar?
We started 14 weeks old, layering over existing training, tons of food, no corrections whatsoever, all low level, pressure on, pressure off. Next.
Campbell's, my dog used to love other dogs until she got attacked by three. Now she tries to attack every dog she sees.
Anyway. Yep. So what it is I'm going to go after you until you after me. So what you've got to do is recognize the sign, correct your dog, always advocate for your dog. get in front of your dog. If other dogs are coming towards your dog, get your dog around other dogs, but not necessarily interacting with your dogs. But at some point you need to find a pack of balanced dogs to have your dog start being around them. It's a multi-step process. You've got to know every dog that you're interacting with next.
Kathy B said, oh, the 11-week-old that is the one she's teaching leash pressure for out. So it would be, yeah, gentle leash guidance.
Oh, gentle leash guidance, yes.
Dark Warrior, good evening, J&J. Are crates required for the seminars? Happy Thanksgiving.
They are, because on day one, I'm only working one dog at a time. But believe it or not, by the afternoon of day one, all dogs are out working. Day two, almost all dogs are working, but it's a safety protocol. Next.
Eddie, I deleted that comment because I tried editing halfway through and the send button decided to say fuck you. So I guess there's that.
So you know the thing is, Eddie, buttons got feelings too. Next. Yeah.
PCBRS. This chair is killing me tonight. Mm-hmm. I have a 4.5-month-old dog. When should or can I get another puppy?
Personally, I'd wait a year.
If you're me, I waited 4.
Okay, but that's all personal choice. Next.
Jacob, any seminars coming up in Jersey?
Yes, Providence,
Rhode Island. Jersey.
Providence, Rhode Island. You're local. You're local this year. Next year, we're going to be in
Mantua,
New Jersey, right across from the Philly line. Mm-hmm. Next.
Joanna, yes, me too. How do you stop a dog from licking me? It's everywhere. Feet, hands, my pants. I mean, this is the only thing that drives me crazy with him. Won't lick anything else except me and himself.
So research Bonker on my page. No and Bonk also teach the OUT command, the out command. Next.
Erica, I said 2-year-old in my question, but I didn't say which dog. So then I did a little 2-year-old golden doodle.
Cool. Thank you, Erica.
Joe said no. He did not work at Camille's.
Okay. Thank you, Joe.
Brooke, hi from Australia.
Hey, Australia. How are you, mate?
Eddie. Oh, my gosh. I got bumped. Here we go. Anyway, stopped a reactive dog lunging the other day after he'd injured about half a dozen other dogs a few months ago. Daycare struggled with him for weeks before dismissing him. Corrected at loading with an e-collar. Sorted out in 5 minutes. Thank you, too, for kicking ass.
Incredible. Incredible.
Mm.
Let's see. Injure 5 dogs.
Right.
Or remote collar. Oh, don't use a remote collar. The dog's injuring dogs. What? Where's your rational thinking here, people? There's so many people that'd be like, oh, the remote collar is bad. No, injuring 5 dogs is bad.
Mm-hmm.
It would have never been fixed. It would have gone to 10 dogs,
yeah.
15 dogs, 20 dogs.
When do you end? When is it done?
It would have never stopped. Next.
Melissa posted a link to our business, JG Media Services. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And if anybody needs any help with video editing, social media content, that's what we do.
Brooke, any tips on how to keep a 6-month-old American Staffy from boredom when I go back to work after COVID?
Get yourself a pet sitter. Look for a daycare. Get up earlier. Run your dog. I don't know what your schedule is going to be. Next.
Peck leader dog training. Hey, J&J, I just got a reactive dog in that I get to bonk. Excited to see results and get my bonking skills back up. Hope you both are doing well.
Excellent. Make sure you're bonking at the first sign of arousal. Always say no first and bonk. Most people think I bonk early. My timing is impeccable, and I've bonked thousands of dogs with incredible results. I show it and demonstrate it live at all my seminars, and we do it here every day. Next.
You look like you're doing good, Susan. Proud of you.
Proud, very, very proud of you.
Clyde said, sup, dudes.
Everything is doing...
Sup, Clyde.
Sup, Clyde. Things are going very, very, very well. But it's a struggle. We're struggling, too. Every single one of us is struggling personally, but we're flipping it. At least I can only speak for Joelle and I, because I know Joelle personally. And, you know, we're working on ourselves. And every day,
all you can do.
Oh, every day we talk, you know, we go through our personal growth exercises together and then independently, and then we talk about them. And then also for the company standpoint, we're always looking for ways to improve the company, to find different revenue streams, because we are a business, to help as many people as possible for free with no obligation of anything in return. So, I mean, we're not planning on going anywhere, because we're going to beat this. Mm-hmm. Next.
Meg, I have the mini educator. The clip keeps breaking. Can you recommend what they sell to carry on my belt to keep it accessible?
They have a couple of things. They have a leather pouch that you can put it in, but do the magnet.
Next. Way better.
Yep.
Missy, love from Washington. I love going to your seminar last year in December with my GSD Chiron. Mm. I just went to learn.
Oh, good. So I don't know what's going to happen with Washington because Seattle's a little bit out of control right now.
Yeah.
A little bit. Interesting things going on there in your city. Next.
Vicky, hi, Jeff and Joelle. Even a wimpy bonk works. Our GSD and Husky respect the bonker.
Good, but bonk strong, bonk firm. Okay? Commit to the bonk.
Jamie, love the stuff you post with Angelo. Adorable.
Good. I just put up two Angelo videos today, and I've got... Oh, can we show this? Can you grab this? Look what Angelo made.
This is so cute. Ooh.
I show this, but you gotta watch. You have to watch. You've got to watch this to get the full effect. Watch this.
You're busting the side out. Careful.
Oh shit! I'll fix it. Watch this, guys, on Angelo's page and on our social media page. Just watch this.
As he breaks it.
No. Angelo made this today.
Little lantern. So cute.
Isn't this cute? He made this.
Better pop that side back in.
I will. I'll fix it later. Next.
Lori, dog keeps biting leash to the point it's broken. He has it on all day for corrections.
So what I would do is get yourself a bonker, bonk the dog for biting the leash, say no, bonk. Usually you can use a pet convincer if you want to. But dogs can bite through leashes in seconds. Next.
Pat said, is a working level of 6 too much?
I don't know. Every dog is different. Depends on the dog. Next.
Kim, can you use an e-collar on a 15-pound 2-year-old multi-poo?
Yeah, they make a micro prong collar. Next.
E-collar. But yes, e-collar. Micro e-collar.
Yep.
J-Ron, would bonker Spanish translation, la chancla tablada.
Yes.
Ooh, I like that.
Ooh,
I like that.
We do a whole thing on.
Rolls off the tongue.
We did a whole thing on the chancla. Yeah. The whole thing actually went up. Yeah.
Super knows all about the bonker, J-Ron.
Yeah, last week. Next.
The day he came in, like, freaking a hot potato. Like, I had to get him down the hallway. And there's dogs in daycare, and he's just, like, trying to fight, like, fence fight with all of them.
Every one of them. He was bonked. Usually, every dog that comes in here on day one, there's...
Normally, I don't have to walk him past the freaking hallway of dogs, though. It's because T3 was going on. That's so, right. Like, I have to go through the gauntlet right now.
So, it's like, there's a lot of bonking that goes on day one with most dogs. Because they come in hot.
They came in like a maniac.
They come in hot. So, they've got to be... told, like, whoa, chill your shit out, buddy. Next.
Ashley said, I have no secrets, so no sweat, Joelle. I have 3 months to prove you wrong, Jeff. LOL, 3 years ago, this would be a bad idea. Love a challenge.
You don't need to prove me wrong.
She's got land and stuff. It'll be a happy
You dog. Don't need to prove me wrong, Ashley.
She's already got a pack of freaking, like, a million German shepherds.
Right, exactly.
Why am I getting bumped so much?
I don't know.
Debbie, awesome. Glad I don't have to buy another collar. I now understand most of my issues with my dog are operator error. I need to learn how to communicate better with her. Thank you for all the videos.
Yeah, I think what's happening is a lot of people have got just bad timing.
Yeah.
Next.
Kelly said, thank you guys. We love and appreciate you.
You're welcome. I appreciate all of you. Next.
Canadian $5 top chat from Dan.
Hey, Dan, no question, but maybe it's down there below. Thank you, Dan. We really appreciate you.
Emma, my dog barks aggressively. Oh, there's Dan.
Yep.
Dog screams uncontrollably like a little girl when on a leash and sees other dogs. She's great off leash and in a dog park. When I correct the prong collar, even lightly, she screams like she's dying.
I know. So you got, first of all, screams like a girl. Let's take that out of there. Let's not be sexist, okay? Because I've heard young boys scream too. All right, we're not going there. Okay, let's empower our young women. Okay, but so Dan, there are some dogs. What you do is this: is it at home, privacy of your own home. put your dog on a collar. Okay, first of all, this is not a prong collar situation. This is a leash situation. We've had dogs scream on a slip lead. So what you're going to do is literally like this. The whole time. For all my folks that are on my podcast, by the way, thank you for everybody that's on Spotify, iHeartRadio. So it's like, you know, what's he doing? Pulling on his dick? It's like, you know, so it's like.
You guys can't see the visual. It's like how weird that
is. What I want you to do is I want you to like, go ahead, keep screaming. Go ahead.
Okay, what he's doing with his fingers is a soft leash pressure pop.
Yep, just keep doing it. Doing it and doing it. It's like, I'm not going to stop until you stop screaming. I'll be here all night long.
Yeah.
Next.
Emma, my dog barks aggressively at a dog that barks and lunges at her at agility. What do you suggest when in this class? I can't use the e-collar because owner teacher is all positive reward based that doesn't believe in this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
She's amazing at agility and would hate for that and would hate to take that from her.
Right. So this is the thing, Emma. This is what I'd like you to do. Hand the dog over to the teacher and say, teach me how to shut my dog up. Next.
Lori, come to North Idaho. We're close enough to Washington. Ooh, I want to go to Idaho.
So Lori, find me a location. I will be in Northern Idaho. Okay. Just for the t-shirt that says Idaho. What is it? Idaho? No, Udaho. I want that t-shirt. Oh, next.
God. You also want a Uranus one?
Why did you have to throw that in?
Because that's like such a silly joke. Idaho, Udaho.
But why do you have to
go Uranus?
But why do you have to go anal on me?
Please.
Why?
It's your favorite topic to talk about.
But why do you have to go anal on me? Joelle.
I couldn't resist.
Next.
Talking about anuses.
Yes.
Kathy, it's cool that you're excited about Angela's schooling and projects.
Yeah, I love it. He did a solar system today.
See? Uranus.
Yep. Oh, you were talking about his solar system. Is that what it was?
Yeah.
That's the segue into his homeschooling.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm going to ask Angela if he'll even say that word.
Dan said awesome lantern.
He'll probably go Saturn, Pluto, Earth, Mercury, and that other planet.
I can't say that word. Nicole.
Next.
Dog runs away when he sees any type of nail clipper. Pulls his paws away from me continuously when I'm trying to trim nails. Advice.
So muzzle up the dog. Put a dog on a slip lead. Say no. Bonk the dog. Grab the dog's paws. Do two people. Go backwards with the paws like a horse. Clip the damn dog's nails. Next.
You know what somebody said today in your video? The kennel one. I noticed you said lipping instead of lip licking.
Did I?
And I didn't correct you on it when I was filming. I just put it up and somebody was like, lipping.
Yes.
Like, I say that all the time.
Yes. Yes.
Jacob, I will see you in Jersey. Have a great Thanksgiving. You both rock.
Thank you. See you soon.
Elise said, any seminars near Eastern Washington?
We're going to be.
She said, Idaho would be an awesome place for a seminar.
Yeah. So, you know.
CDA? What's CDA?
It's probably one of the cities. It's probably the capital or a main city. I don't know.
Either.
I don't know. Yeah, I'm not familiar with all the cities in Idaho. Next.
Idaho's pretty. I want to go. Dan says, thanks, you too.
You're welcome. Thank you, Dan.
Lori's laughed at my Uranus jokes.
That's good.
Elise, any seminars near Eastern Washington? I think we already said this.
Yeah.
Jamie, we love watching you too. Cracks me up.
Thank you. I'm just saying, you know, what time did you get up today? 3:30? 4?
3:45.
Yeah. So I was up early. I woke up for the first time at 1, went back to bed. I got up at about 3:30. And this is the thing. Right before this show, I was exhausted. And then I sat down, rested. I listened to some really good stuff. I downloaded a ton of stuff of edited videos. I uploaded a bunch of stuff that needed to be edited. I've got some content. I think they'll make 3 good videos, some with Angelo in it. And then I got ready for this show, and this is like, it's almost like a second wind. The show's like a second wind. You know, it's like back when I used to do triathlons, you know, it's like, you know, there is something actually called the second wind when you're, when you're, when you compete, and or when you don't, even when you don't compete. And I used to love getting my second wind, and I really, really love doing this show. Next.
Jamie said, I already read that. Emma, it drives me nuts. She's like, just distract her with treats. And I'm thinking to myself, if I had my collar, it wouldn't go that far. And with treats, I feel like I'm rewarding her bad behavior. LOL.
Yeah. So we, by the way, we use tons of food to train a dog, but it's a positive motivator.
Yeah. So if you're agility and your dog's reacting, you're giving her treats, you are rewarding the bad behavior. Yeah.
So distract her with treats. So again, give the dog to your trainer and say, show me how to do it. Next.
Kathy laughed my ass off at Joelle. See, it's Uranus.
Yeah, that was funny.
Got jokes. Leslie, what would you suggest for family coming over for the holidays, unfortunately, and having a reactive dog? Some tips.
Crate your dog, mandatory downstay. Next.
I'm not going to read that one.
Okay.
That's it right now. Oh, hold on. It's 7:55 anyway. Paul, is food resource aggression 100% trainable, or is there a genetic component where you will always be, have to be vigilant because the dog will always be inclined to resource guard?
So, Paul, I personally, and I demonstrate it at 100% of my seminars, I tell people how to do it on all of my one-on-ones. We do it here on most dogs. Well, actually, we teach it here on most on almost every dog. I stop resource guarding in 1 to 3 seconds. I stop it, and I stop it cold. Literally, I stop it cold. I stop the physical act of resource guarding and the mental act of resource guarding, meaning your dog does not want to guard resources, not just food, which is common, any resource. We stop resource guarding. We don't manage it. We stop it cold. It goes away. Highly effective. I have a video on it. I have multiple videos on it. I demonstrate it. 1 to 3 seconds. All right, get yourself a remote collar. Step by step, the instructions are in a free video on my YouTube channel. 1 to 3 seconds. And I say that because a lot of people are struggling with it, and you don't need to struggle with it. You can eliminate it in seconds. And a lot of people will say, oh, well, they tried that method and it made the dog aggressive, more aggressive. I'm sorry. Not to be rude, you did it wrong then. Why? I've never seen a dog get aggressive with my technique. It's not my technique, but the technique that we use to stop resource guarding. All I've done is seen dogs stop resource guarding. That's all I've ever seen. I literally do it at seminars, live in front of people. Next.
$5 top tap from Pat, and this will probably be the last one. What's a good training project for confidence builder? My GSD has no confidence at all. Afraid of bonker, e-collar, and leash.
Well, first of all, the dog should be afraid of the bonker.
Yeah.
The e-collar they should love and then also be concerned about. All right? And a leash, a dog should love a leash. So, Joelle, what's a couple of good resources, or what's a couple of good protocols that people can do for confidence building?
Well, I would start with counter conditioning the leash fear. If the dog's not even letting you gear it up, I would do all click reward, and like make the leash a really good thing. And then up, over, and through, get the dog to go over stuff, under stuff. I like to utilize like playgrounds, which are pretty much empty these days because of COVID anyway. So bring him to a kid's playground, have him jump on benches, climb up and down things. and get them out in public.
Yeah. And then general obedience, train your dog up. That builds a lot of confidence. Hold your dog accountable. That builds confidence. Mm-hmm. Find things your dog is struggling with and work them through it. That builds confidence. All right. Okay. End of the show. I'm madly in love with you. Joelle, feeling pretty good about everybody?
Mm-hmm. Love you guys.
Good. Excellent. Awesome. I want you to know.
We'll see everybody on Wednesday, though, right?
Good show.
I was going to say, everybody have a great
Thanksgiving. Leaving me hanging like that? Yep.
But we're going to see everybody before Thanksgiving?
Yeah, I think we might switch. We were doing a Patreon only. We're going to maybe switch that up and make the Wednesday one public again because we want to be able to help more people. But we're going to come up with a new thing.
We might have to do a little bit later of a show on Wednesday, though, because I have a lot of food I have to cook.
Oh, you have to cook. All right, just let me know. Let me know. We'll announce it. We'll announce it. I mean, when you say later, we'll just probably start at 8 o'clock. Yeah. All right. Madly in love with all of you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Good night.